Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Kerbal Space Program. This is the Jeff Space Program, and this is version 0.18. It's finally here, and here's the news. I don't know anything about this update. I know a couple of things. I guess that's not a factual statement, the first one I made. I know that they've added docking, which is dope as heck, and they've added unmanned space pods, so like satellites that you don't have to sacrifice the life of a poor Kerbal to live in like space celibacy and starve to death. And a bunch of other stuff too, like batteries and electric power, and they've changed the interface and stuff. I have not played with this very much. I took one quick look at it. Hey, look at that. That's just perfect for me. Success, but at what cost? So we're actually going to start a new Jeff Space program here. I do have the old Jeff Space program. I almost put two F's in there. That is fucked up. Wait, plural. The game is like, no. There's only one of you motherfuckers. So right away you'll notice a huge difference. Look at this. There's no thing in the center. There's no like, hey, bro, welcome to Kerbal Space Program. You're shit. This is the new pod selection thingy, and it actually does something really neat. Like, I guess we'll... Here's the Stay Putnik Mark II. There's no Stay Putnik Mark I, but we have the Stay Putnik Mark II, which is an unmanned vessel. There's a whole bunch of new parts in here, too. Like, new engines and new fuel thingamajiggers. All sorts of new thingamajiggers. And there's actually, like, a science pod where you can have a detector of barometer, thermogenometers, all kinds of craziness going on in there. And I don't know, I don't think there's any new wings, but what is that? A radial air intake? Let's put one of those on here. No, like, damn, that is sweet. Oh, that is the best. I can put a hat on this thing. Dude, it looks like it's Ridley Scott made this spacecraft. Anyway, I guess I really need to familiarize myself with these menus because they're new. There's also action groups in this. I don't know why, what they do, or how they work. So, if you're looking for someone to teach you how to play the new version of Kerbal Space Program, look somewhere else. I'm sure there's plenty of people. But I'm not one of them. Damn, that just looks fucking amazing. I don't know why. Alright, so one of the other really neat things is that you can actually add multiple space pods to this thing. Like, if I add this, this will be an unmanned, empty space pod. If you start with this, it'll start with a Kerbal Man inside of it. But it won't, because I didn't. There's other structural things, too. Like, for example, this is a radial coupler thingy, and you can actually dock and undock from this. So, the idea is that you could create a space station, and I plan to do that. Not this video, but I do plan to do that. Maybe I could start in this video, but that would be a multiple stage process. Where you can launch this fucker into space, and then you can launch something else and connect it, and then launch something else and connect it, and then etc., 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 until you've got a spaceship the size of the Mun. And I plan to do that. It'll be called the Mun 2.0. I don't actually plan to do that. But something really neat is adding on these. Look, I made testicles. This is balls. I wonder how this thing flies. How does this fly? This is our first spaceship in Kerbal Space Program 0.18. Balls! Go to space! Maximum thrust! Go to space! Oh, it didn't work. But you can see there's no Kerbals in here. We can control it, and if you look at our resources here, there's actually an electric charge, and this thing doesn't have any solar power collectors or any other way to gain charge. Cool, I made a rover. I made space testicles that rove. Look at this. Oh man, they can walk too. Look at that! Damn, it's the Walking Balls. It's a new show on AMC. You should check it out. Except skip season 2 because it sucks. topical. Anyway, I guess I've made some space balls. Speaking of references, whoa, oh no, I wanted it to dance. Dance for me. Dance, little robot balls. I guess we'll leave these here as sort of a monument to my ingenuitive spacecraft design. There's been a number of other changes too, including the visuals of the world. Look at that. Look at that. That is madness. That is insanity, and I love it. That is dope as heck. And you can see we got a little space, balls at Kerbal Space Program. That is definitely what's going on here. We got a fantastic set of balls. Stop. No. What? Oh, I see. It's because... Yeah, there's also a whole bunch of other thingies, like fucking state operational control from here, name vessel, etc. It's crazy. There's all sorts of stuff. And so I'm going to have a really, really, really rough time with this in the beginning because it is so freaking new. Let me take a look at my battery level here. Have we run out? I kind of wanted to run these batteries out. We can put those on here. And I don't know if I can move these. Well, that's kind of annoying, but it'd be cool if I could move these over here or something like that. Anyway, when these run out of charge, I think if they just sit here... Whoops. Okay. I think if they just sit here, yeah, it'll just run out of... So I'll run these out of charge. And it'll show off the reason that you need to have batteries and power generators or solar combobulators on here. Because if you don't, then your balls will become stranded. Now I can't rotate my balls anymore. Phooey. Oh, how do I get that to go away? There we go. All right. So, there is the permanent space balls stuck at Kerbal Space Command. Let's end that flight. No, never mind. I want to go to Space Center. I don't want to end the flight. I want those balls to remain. But I think what we're going to start with here is I want to see if we can build a spacecraft using the new tools and parts system. And I'll do an unmanned flight. What is this? This is an octo. I should have probably read that. Beginner's level core. Simple geometry and lots of flat surfaces for attaching equipment. Okay, that sounds fun. There's also a box. They're onto our boxcraft plan. I guess what we could do is launch... I don't really want to put a satellite up. I want to start building a space station, and I don't want anything else. I just want a space station. So, for a first bit here... I guess what we're going to do is launch up probably a core, like a connector. I need probably maybe an adapter or something like that. Okay, in the utility tab, you can find various different docking parts, like the Clamp-O-Tron docking thing, the Clamp-O-Tron Jr., which would be a tip of the port thingy, and oh my goodness. And there's like, ion propulsion systems or something like that? I don't know. And there's a gigantic... Oh, that, does that one have multiple? No, it's just one. It's an inline single port thingy. Maybe that's what we'll launch up. We'll launch up one of these. What's this? Shielded docking port? Oh, that's cool. It's shielded. It's like... It's got a fucking shield on it. Yeah. We'll put a docker on the tip here. But just the tip. So that if we need to, we can dock another part to this tip thingy. And then we're going to need... let's put a battery pack. I don't really think this... Yeah, I guess we'll put a battery pack there. And we'll probably need some solar power thingies. There's a radial-mounted parachute. That's kind of cool. Thermoelectric generator. Natural decay of plutonium. Power generator. Consistent stable power for decades. That sounds like exactly what I need. I don't get it, but no, I'd rather have solar panels. Where's my old fuel tanks? The little ones. Little teeny weenies. Where'd they go? Are they gone? We don't have them anymore? What? That's huge. Why would anyone want something that huge? What is this? That's a tiny little fuel tank. It's an Oscar B. Backup tank for small spacecraft. No, that's not exactly what I'm looking for. I want this thing. What am I supposed to connect this to? Everything's too big. Let me look around a bit, and I'll be back. Where is it? This guy right here, a electric propulsion system. It doesn't use liquid or solid fuel. It uses electric charge and very little xenon gas. So you could create something like this, and if this were in space, this would have its own propulsion system using the electric charge gained from these deployable solar panels and the xenon gas contained therein. I don't know how that would work in the atmosphere, but I don't think it will provide very, very much thrust. I think I can extend the panels on these solar jiggers here. Like so. And then, yeah, we're gaining electric charge. It's up to 100% now. So I think if I did that, then in theory... and it's using the battery, but doesn't give me any thrust at all. I don't know if that would give me any thrust in space or not. Because, again, I don't completely understand this, so that does cause a problem. But the fact that something like this could be, you know, like, pilotable, something this small could be pilotable in space, is pretty dope in and of itself. Why don't I see if I can just get this into space and see what we can do with it? I'm going to put a normal tip on this. It's just a parachute. Because I don't want to be losing this thing. We should probably make this battery symmetrical. There we go. We got two batteries, two solar panels, and then this thingy. And then we'll just see if we can get this into space and see what it can do. I will need a coupler. Please, sir, may I have a coupler? That's a teeny weeny little. Look at it, cute. And then we can put, like, an adapter on here. Probably not going to take much to get this little fella into space. So, should be easy, and I'm going to build a little... I'm going to build a little rocket. Not too ginormous. Can I couple this fella? Sure. Whoa, hey, cool. It, like, closed up the gap there, so it created a solid rocket. Oh, man, that is awesome. There's so many cool changes in this. It's, like... cool, man. I said that's a big, huge rocket. I guess we could see if that works. Because, shit, why not? What is this? Oh, yeah, this is the last stage engine. No, I want my little ion engine to be up here. I don't think this is going to go into space. I don't really want to build a too complicated a rocket here. Because, yeah, I'll turn this into a tricoupler, and then we'll go. And this will just be our xenon tester. And I'm going to tricouple this, and that should be enough. Okay, I made it kind of big, just because I like big rockets, and I you know, I want to be sure that this fucker's going to get up there. I did add an SAS module on this. They changed the SAS a little bit, too. It is much less heavy. That's kind of loud. But we're going! There's a street sweeper going by my house, so it's not a really good time, but I did want you to let you know that this one has vectoring, even though these engines didn't say they did. And I'm going to fly this guy up, hopefully somewhere near space, where we can play around with our thingamajigger in space. Alright, I'm sort of doing a gravity burn, but I started it late. Anyway, I just wanted to watch this decoupling. Oh, that's cool. Anyway, it uncircumcised the engine or whatever. But yeah, we're still doing our sort of ridiculous gravity turn, because it's not working very well, and I started it too late. And apparently we're going very high up. Either way, we're going to be able to achieve an orbit with this in a bit, and then we can decouple and see what this fella can do all by his lonesome. Alright, the street sweeper's slowly going away, but either way, we've achieved orbit now with this little fella. And I'm a little curious about something, but I think if I were to add another module onto this, like another... one of these control modules on here and add it just below here, because you can control from different areas. So what I could do is I could decouple this and then I could manually set it to deorbit itself, but I'm not going to do that for this one. We're just going to decouple. And now we are this little guy. Whee! So this doesn't have any docking stuff. This is just to see if I've got the understanding of the xenon electrical charge stuff going on here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to deploy my solar condobulators. That's the technical term. You wouldn't understand. Now that we're far enough away that we won't smash into that thing. If we could stop rotating, that'd be pretty sweet. Okay, so now we have a little solar thingy. That already looks fucking rad. Like, I'm just telling you how rad that looks right now. And the solar panels are pointed at the sun automatically. Now, I want to fire this engine up. And we got ourselves a little engine. And hey, look, we're thrusting. Let's see if we can go... Stop! Stop. Okay, no. Let's see if we can rendezvous with this thing. Now, we can't dock with it, because I didn't add any docking pods. But all that fucking street sweeper, man. Okay. Eh. This is awesome. Yeah, this isn't using... How much xenon fuel do we have left? Oh, man, we barely even touched it, and we're... Okay, so it does actually drain the battery faster than it can automatically charge itself, but if we just do small controlled thrust, we shouldn't be... Oh, no! No, my panel! Oh! Oh, that was... Oh, no! I hit it! Oh, no! Come back! Also, I think because of how I'm maneuvering this... Stop it. Partially the problem is that I'm the solar panels are constantly having to try to find the sun again, so it's not, they're not charging, like, right now. Now they're charging. Or no, they're not. Well, they're sort of charging. Come back, you fucking bastard. But this kind of propulsion system could get us very far, because we've got an unlimited amount of sun, and, this is not a manned vehicle, so we've got an unlimited amount of time. You know, assuming that the AI doesn't starve to death like a Kerbal would. Actually, the Kerbals don't, but, you know, if we're going to be, like, trying to think about how to get to other planets and stuff, we're going to need to send probes and shit first. And this would be a very good way to go about doing that. We've managed to very efficiently get this up into the atmosphere, and we can modify its orbit and things. I would not want to do a orbital burn with this engine, though, because the thrust is very, very low. But we have managed to fly circles around this thing here, and that's pretty cool. How much is xenon gas? We've used 3. And our solar panels are still getting exposure. And we're still sort of in orbit with this fella here. I'll get a little closer to him. Normally you'd want to do this with, like, RCS thrusters or something, so that you could have three-dimensional control. But this would be one way to dock with something, to have a little ship like this. And this is, you have to admit, fucking rad. This is, like, rad. If you haven't bought this game, even if you don't like this game, just go buy it, just to support these guys. Let's drive this. Let's punch it with our little ion fucker. Get down onto the planet. We're gonna deorbit you. Look at how much visually has changed, too. There's, like, texturing on that thing and shit. Cool. Let's see. How's our battery doing? Oh, you can actually see it's, we're running out of battery as we fire our little engine. It's sputtering. If we point it more towards the sun, though, yeah, it's firing faster, because we're getting more power. And if we let it charge for a second, whoop, that's cool. That's fucking sweet. All right, so I do have an understanding of the xenon gas and the electricity stuff, and a little bit of an understanding about how this orbiting thing works, so can I switch over to this xenon tester thingy? I've targeted the xenon tester debris. There's some other stuff that I want to show you guys, too. They've added a... What the fuck? Look at that. I don't even know. I don't even know. Yeah, there's all kinds of shit. Anyway, we're going to end this flight, and we are actually going to end the... Whoopsie. End the rotation of this dock, because I'm not willing to have a satellite yet. I only want to have one thing in orbit around... Oh, I have to go to balls before I can switch to this. Actually, I don't know if I can switch to this. I might need to send something up to deorbit it manually, because... No, I don't want to target it. I want to end it. I want to end its life. I want it to die. Okay, I think I'm going to make a new space program. That's the best thing to do here. Don't worry, I'll make a new set of balls. The balls have been redeployed. Okay, so with that in mind, now we can start working on the first part of our space station. So we're going to make the Jeff Space Program. Yeah, we'll make the JSS Habitation. I think that's going to be the first part we launch. Unless it's not, because I don't know. What do we have here? A lander can, not what I'm looking for. I think I want this to be unmanned. So what we could do is we could add one of these cores and then add a command pod later that would be able to hold crew members. A spacious cabin can hold a maximum of 3 crew. That would be good. Although I don't know if there are parts that cover that as well. Why don't I add the two-seated lander can? Why don't I go ahead and put this as the core? This will be just the tip. I did see something about, like, there's a cargo container. 4 Kerbals on orbit without any real provisions for return. Okay, so I guess this is just a cargo container. It's just all it is. It's got shit in it. And I guess we're going to need one of those, but not right now. What we need is a habitation module, and I don't think that there's any... Yeah, we're going to have to put something like this on here. Not exactly like that, but if we do this, you'll see, and I launch this, even though this is a crew module, it is actually empty. There's no one in here. Not enough crew, 0 out of 1? What? That doesn't make sense. I can also switch control to this, so I can control using this thingy. Fucking street sweeper, man. God damn it. So this will be our crew capsule, because This is the biggest one. That doesn't look like it fits very well. I think there might be a better adapter. No, that one's not right. And I don't know what I'm doing here. But we're going to figure it out. I guess that'll have to do for our crew module thingy. Can I put a... This would be good if I could put a docking situation on this. That's too small. Yeah, something like this. There we go. So now what we could do is we could separate, and then this would be the crew module, and I could attach to the front of it. I'd rather have it attach something to the rear end of it, because this is a small docking port, and I like big docking ports. And butts. We could put a cargo container. Yeah, well, since we got the crew module on here, we might as well have the cargo container attached. So this will be the habitation module. Supplies and Kerbal storage, where we can store our space Kerbals when we deliver them. And so that sounds like a good idea. This is going to be our objective, is to get this fucking thing into space. Hooray! Without any Kerbals in it. I don't know what to put at the bottom of this, though. Let me think about this for a minute. Alright, so I went ahead and put some RCS thrusters on the end of this guy here. I don't really know what's going on with these stages. That doesn't really make a lot of sense. But what we're going to do is add some solar arrays onto this guy as well. Maybe we could just add some thermoelectric generators to it. I think we want to have energy here. I think this is what the module is going to look like when it's deployed, is it's going to look something like this. That's the idea, and then we'll dock a hub connector to this guy here, which we can build off of. But this will be the base of the beginning of the space station. This is our habitation module. It's got a little bit of control. It's got communication systems, power, electricity, and it's got food and supplies and storage for hopefully 3 Kerbals, if I'm not mistaken. But now we got to get this bitch into space. We're going to go ahead and do an asparagus stock system on this. Okay, this is confusing as dick, but I think I figured it out. If you do this the old way, where you try to select like a part out of this, it will collapse it. But if you double-click it, and you find the part you want, you can drag that out of the group. So I think that's what you have to do now. And I don't know if... Oops, I didn't double-click it right. I don't know if that's going to be something I'm doing wrong or what, or if that's just how we have to do it from now. I don't necessarily like it. I don't know, maybe I can do a group thingamajigger here. Oh, where did it go? Oh, for some reason it went up here. Alright, I'm really curious. This looks awesome. This looks way cool. This is one of the coolest looking rockets I've had. I put the nose cones on here just because I wanted to enhance the coolness of it. I didn't want to have any jagged edges sticking out, although this part is pretty jagged. That's 2 SAS units stuck together. Whatever. I don't care. We're just gonna fly it. Need that much thrust. Yes, that's much more stable. Excellent. There we go, that's plenty. Alright, so I'm gonna cut the engines here. And now what I'm gonna do is, this is our trajectory. This is where we're going to be. And I want to get this into orbit. We've got a fresh set of fuel here. In fact, we've got a little bit too much. What I'm going to do is click right here before the apoapsis, and we're going to add a maneuver. I don't know how to use this. I think I want to burn towards that. Oh my god. Whoa. No. Not that. Not exactly that. We want to... Okay, well... No, I don't want to add any more maneuvers. I want less... Holy jeez. Holy bejeebies. No, we want an orbit, bro. How do I tweak this guy? There we go. Oh, this is cool. Okay, what do we got? 94, 150... That's not quite right. Whoa, that was good. 111 and 160. Can we get those a little bit closer? No, other way. 110. I think we're about to do the maneuver, so I better figure this out quick. What we could do is just add another maneuver. Like right here. We'll add another maneuver. this is so weird. I want to shrink this. What do we got? 150 and... 125, 120, whoop, there we go, perfect. Alright, so now we've planned out 2 maneuvers. I don't know if these are going to happen or not. I don't know if it will automatically do these or what, but... Or maybe it's just going to tell me when I need to do them or something. Nope, it wants me to do it. That's fine, I have no problem with that. So we're doing our burn. All these lines now are totally screwing me up here. I don't think I should have done that. I think I should have just done this manually. It'd be cool if you could get it to automatically do this stuff. What does this mean? What is going on with that? I don't understand what you're talking about, but okay. But I think that that orbital planning system is going to be mostly efficient for when you're trying to intersect solar bodies that are out of, you know, doing massive changes in your... I should be going fast enough for an orbit, yeah. Okay, we got 110, we got 170. How do I get rid of these maneuvers? Go away. Don't want you anymore. No, don't abort. Oh, there we go. Right click. Goodbye, maneuver. 110, 112, close enough. So what I'm going to do here is there's a little bit of fuel left in this. I'm going to separate this stage here. We got an unsheathing operation. This stage has been completely redundant now. This one, I didn't add any piloting things to it. Let me go ahead and switch to this real quick. This is a dead stage. Supposedly it still has some fuel in it. Oh yeah, it did, that's right. I'm going to end this stage's flight, and we'll go to the tracking station, and we'll go back to the habitation module. All right, now, this stage right here, why are we falling so quickly? It looks like we're falling. Well, I guess that is orbit. So we have RCS thrusters, I can turn those on and we can use those, but I don't want to waste the fuel. What orbit do we want? Do we want this to be a super low orbit space station? I think that might be a good idea. You can always modify your orbit later. There's no real reason to have a super high orbit space station. So I think this is what we're going to work with. Now, we can do all sorts of burning maneuvers with this guy here, but I don't really want to. But I also don't have a reason to get rid of it. There's absolutely no reason. We can thrust with this and use it to our advantage in any way we want, but there's no reason at all to jettison this. It might as well stay attached to the space station, so if we ever need to move the space station, we can totally do that. It's a very large piece to begin with, but I guess this is going to be our habitation mod. I should have put some lights on this thing. There are lights in this now, and I didn't put any. We do have our antennas, though. What can I do with my antennas? Nothing. They are antennas. Shut up. all right, so what we can do now is detach this next stage here. I don't want to detach that. Can I not detach that? Yeah, we can manually do a detachment up here. This guy. Let's do a decoupling. Bingo. There is our command module, and that's not good. Something's wrong. So we've got some things to learn, apparently. But we have this engine here, which has no fuel pods! Fuck my life. Alright, so I've dramatically simplified this a little bit and also overcomplicated it. I don't know how the hell these things got up here, but it kind of looks cool in a way, and I bet it'll be super stable. I added a fuel tank onto this one, because herp derp. Also, I took off the solar panels here. I'll add them back on, but I wanted to change that. And I've taken away that intermediary stage because we absolutely did not need it. So now this is going to be the intermediary stage, and this is going to be our final product, except we're missing a few things. One really cool thing I didn't know you could do is these docking things. We can just slap these bitches on the sides of this thing. So we've got two docking ports on the habitation module, which is awesome. So we don't have to worry about putting one at the end or at the top or anything like that. Oh yeah, I wanted to add some lights to this because it does have this new lighting system. So we'll add lights like we could probably put them. Here would be good. We'll have three lights there, so we can light up the night. And now those will have power and stuff. So I think this is actually going to work, I hope. So we're going to try again. Hopefully not fail this time. We will see, but I'm really happy because the street sweeper is not at my house anymore. That is thrilling to me. So, in honor of not having my street sweeped anymore, let's go. So far, so good. I'll see you in space. We are up, and I decided to shoot for something around 150,000. It's a little bit safer, and we have our habitation debris falling, predictably. And here we're going to do our orbital burn. We are down to this set of fuel tanks, but they have full fuel in them. And then we can start messing around with this thing to see what we can do with it. Because I think what I can do is control this thingy here. And it does have an electrical charge in it. And we do have batteries that are full right now. Haven't turned on the lights yet. I don't know if that'll drain the batteries or not. But we have the crew. Apparently that's a crew hatch. Oh, it can hold 4 crew members in it. Well, damn. And this one can hold 3. So, yeah, this is a hell of a habitation module. We could put a fucking circus troupe up here. We made a clown car. Dude, we made a clown car! All right. let's do our orbital burn here. Awesome. So this looks pretty cool. Let's go ahead and start deploying our stuff here. We want to be pointed... Let's go ahead and point it, like, straight away from the planet for now. We can always reorient this. Let's deploy our satellite, our solar panels. Where's the other one? There's only 2. And actually what we ought to do is go like this. Although I don't think we even need these solar panels because we've also got these guys here. They're operating at 100% efficiency, which is way more than my brain has ever operated at. All right, we're tumbling. I don't know why. My orientation's all screwed up. Let's just point it at the sun. All right, and now it's got these 2 little docking modules here. I want this thing to cool out because I don't want it to be spinning. So we are going to dock with this. We're going to want it to be not spinning. Now, let's see what happens. Can I turn on the lights? Okay, I can turn on the lights. That's not enough light. I should have added more lights. But it does do something. We can see the docking ports a little bit better. I should have had a light directly over this if I'm ever going to try to dock with this. And this light is blocked by this thing, so what? is this using power? I don't think it is, but it doesn't really matter. We can also use the RCS thingies here to do, what the hell? Apparently U powers lights on. That's cool. But that used to be one of the RCS controls. I don't really know how these work anymore. It doesn't really matter. We have them, and we have our ship, and we can keep these lights on. And I think now I can set this to control from here, but I'm not going to. What we're going to do is go back to control from here. And I think we're going to separate this next stage and leave this up here. That's a very small solar panel, man. We need bigger ones. We need gigantic ones. Actually, it's just that this portion here is very, very big. So this is how you get into it. I'm glad I didn't block those off. Or it off with the solar panel on accident. It could have very easily happened. Alright, so let's go. Ugh. And we want to deorbit this now. So this is our little command podule thingy. And if I burn in this direction, I don't know how much fuel we're going to have to work with here. But I think we're going to wait a minute here. We'll burn at the periapsis just so that we've had a little time to separate from the habitation module. Bye, habitation module. Bye. See you later. See, this is what's crazy, is that we're technically on the same orbit, but even so, just a minor variation of separating from it caused me to fly, like, you know, 5 kilometers away from the fucking thing. And hopefully we'll have enough fuel to get this guy out of orbit so that I don't... I could just end flight it, but I like doing it, you know, the cool way. Oh, shit. That's a problem. I ran out of electrical charge. But I think what I can do is just wait for this to get towards the periapsis, and then I can fire the engine. Apparently, it's very important to add batteries and solar panels to everything. That's really good to know. I can't even fire the engine. Yeah, it's completely ran out of power. What a dick. That's awesome. It's exactly the way I wanted it to be. Okay, so let's go make a rendezvous ship with a docking module port. Exhaust. Snooty. Bang, bang. This is just going to be a shuttle, basically.